हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज फिफ्थ पार्ट ऑफ योर फोर्थ चैप्टर एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज सॉर्टिंग मटेरियल्स इनटू ग्रुप्स। टुडे वी विल डू सम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। सो फर्स्ट वी विल डू short question answer. So take your notebook and write it. Answer the following question in brief, short questions. Your first question is, the first question is, name any three objects having rough surface. Name any three objects having rough surface. So the answer is three objects having rough surface are the bark of tree, rock and sandpaper. Bark of tree, rock and sandpaper. These are the three objects having rough surface. Now see the next question. Students, take the screenshot of this question and answer. Now see the next question, question number 2. Write a short note on texture. What is mean by texture? Texture means how the thing feel to touch. That is texture. Okay, so write the answer. And the answer is, if you feel different when you touch different materials as they have different textures. They may rough or smooth. So can you tell me the name of rough and smooth things? Okay, rough things are given here, bark of tree, question number 1. You can see rough things are given here, bark of tree, rock and sandpaper. And can you tell me the name of smooth things? Smooth things can be glass and what? Just think it. Marble. Or you can see the tiles. These are the smooth things. Okay, now we'll see the next question, question number 3. Mention any three materials that are soft. Three materials that are soft. The three materials that are soft are rubber, cotton, and third one is Isnu. Rubber, cotton and Isnu. Now see question number 4. What materials are good conductors of heat? What materials are good conductors of heat? Conductors of heat means those materials which can absorb the heat. Those materials are called good conductors of heat. So look, the answer is given here. Generally, metals are good conductors of heat. Write the answer. Generally, metals are the good conductor of heat. Take the screenshot of this answer, question answer number 2. Now take the screenshot of this, these two question answer, question number 3 and 4. Now let's see the next question. Question number 5. And the question is, what materials are bad conductors of heat? What materials are bad conductors of heat? So all the non-metals such as wood, plastic, glass, bamboo, air and paper. These things are bad conductors of heat, means these things cannot absorb heat. So take the screenshot of this question answer. Now see the next question. Okay. Now we will see, answer the following question in detail. These are the long question answer. We'll see the long question answer. And your first question is,
Look here. Your first question is, what is classification and how is it useful? Here two questions are given. Two questions are given here. What is classification and how is it useful? What is classification and how is it useful? Okay, let's see the answer. And the answer is, the method of grouping objects, the method of grouping objects on the basis of certain similarities and dissimilarities. Similarities means how they look alike or how they look different is called classification. Classification enables, this sentence you have to write from the next para. Classification enables us to make a systematic study of anything. For example, if you observe the way things have been stocked in your kitchen, you will find that various items are classified. Okay, now take the screenshot of this question answer so that you can write it easily. Okay, let's see the next question. Okay, see here. Look. The second question is, how is grouping of materials advantageous? How is grouping of materials advantageous? And the answer is, placing or sorting similar things together is called grouping. Grouping makes it easier for us to find things when we need them. A good example of grouping can be seen in supermarket. Do you know what is supermarket? Supermarket is a place where you can buy almost all types of things. Supermarket is a place where you can buy different types of things at one place, that is supermarket. In supermarket there can be separate portions for items of various types. Okay, students. Now you can take the screenshot of this question answer. Take the screenshot. Okay, now let's see the question number 3. Okay, here you are looking question number 3, and the question is, what are transparent and translucent materials? Give examples. What are transparent and translucent materials? Give examples. And the answer is, look here, if almost all the light can pass through an object, it is called transparency. We can see through a transparent material such as air, water, and clear glass. Okay, look here, you can see this bottle. And you can see the liquid inside this bottle. Can you see it? You can see because this bottle is transparent. That's why we can say that the light can pass through an object. It is called transparency. If light can pass through an object partially, means light is passing but it is not passing completely, so it is called translucence. If light can pass through an object partially. It is called translucence. We cannot clearly see through a translucent material. We cannot see through a translucent material such as frosted glass. Means you can say that if the glass is colored, then you cannot see the things clearly inside it. Turbid water means if the water is not clear. And dust laden air means air, such type of air. Which contain dust, that is called dust laden air. Okay, students, now take the screenshot of this question answer number 3. Now let's see the question number 4. Question number 4. The question is given here. Define the solubility in water. Give examples. Define the solubility in water. Give examples. And the answer is, some materials are soluble in water, whereas some are insoluble. As you can see, sugar and salts are soluble in water, but some of the things like dust and oil, it is not soluble. These things are not soluble in water, so we can say that these are insoluble. Actually, some materials are soluble in water, whereas some are insoluble. Actually, water causes all molecules in a solid piece of sugar to break apart. The individual molecules, when separated, are so small that we cannot see them. We can say that sugar is soluble in water. Some solids like sugar, common salt, potassium permanganate. Sugar, common salt, and potassium permanganate are soluble in water. Do you know what is potassium permanganate? The formula of potassium permanganate is KMnO4. Look here, how you can write KMnO4. K will be capital, M will be capital, N will be small, O will be capital, and 4 will be written here like this. KMnO4. This is known as potassium permanganate. And this potassium permanganate used to purify the water, which is used in water plants. Now take the screenshot of this question and answer. Okay, let's see the next question. Define the features of luster. Define the features of luster. Do you know what is mean by luster? Luster mean a metallic shine. You may have noticed that the surface of some materials is shiny. Some surface of some materials is shiny, while of others is rather dull. This sign of the materials is called luster. If you carefully look at the variety of objects, you will observe that materials that generally show luster are metals. Mostly metals are lustrous. This property of metals is widely used for making jewelry. Metal is used for making jewelry, other decorative objects, materials such as gold, silver, and bronze have luster. Students, the question answers are finished. Take the screenshot of this question answer. Two more lines are remaining here. Now take the screenshot of these two lines. Okay, students, your word meanings and question answers are finished. In the next video, we will see some activities and some questions, project related questions and activities, and that will be the sixth part of your fourth chapter. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, goodbye.